Red phosphorus is one of the several isotopes of phosphorus. It is relatively stable and safe to handle, unlike its cousin, white phosphorus. Its stability makes it a key ingredient on the side of matchboxes, and for the average chemist, that striker pad is the most accessible source of phosphorus. So in this video, we are extracting red phosphorus from matchboxes. The materials we need for this experiment are matchboxes and a blade or a knife to scrape off the phosphorus. To get the phosphorus, we dab the striker part of the box with some water and leave it for about 10 seconds. Then we scrape off the phosphorus with a blade. We don't want it to soak for too long as it will make the box soggy. And if it doesn't soak long enough, you'll be scraping off cardboard. This is our target. This tiny smear is all the phosphorus a single striker pad gives us. So it's clear that we will need a lot of boxes and even more patience to get a usable amount. After scraping all 10 boxes, we are left with red phosphorus and some contaminants. To wash the glue and cardboard impurities, we soak our mixture with ethanol. Once the washing is done, we decant the cardboard impurities and let the ethanol evaporate. Now, we have our significantly pure phosphorus, free of contaminants. The amount of phosphorus from this batch is small, which shows that for this experiment, you need real dedication. Before filming this video, I had stripped about 100 boxes and I got a very decent yield. So the rule is simple: more boxes plus more patience equals more phosphorus. Now that we have our purified red phosphorus, we can move on to some spectacular reactions. I plan to use it to make acids, prepare the Armstrong's mixture, and synthesize its cousin, white phosphorus. If you want fun tools to those experiments, make sure you are subscribed to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.